I see enough waste of talent of actors in America. I see a waste of writing talent, waste of directing talent. Why not have a theater where there's a place where you try to do something about it and fill that gap where talented work can get on, even if it's not considered commercial? So that.
Just out of college and was trying to find someone to study with, they all recommended Wynn Handman. Wynn was renowned for his ability to nurture people, for them to gain their confidence.
If you see the way he deals with young actors, you can tell his enormous love of actors and respect of the craft.
You're doing very well. You've got nice things. Excellent.
He created an atmosphere where people could risk their imaginations.
Wynn drew from me and from all of his students what was theirs to give.
Wynn was really great to bring back to reality and go, you know what, the playwright's words are, that's what you have to respect.
What I like is the language just flows right out of them. It's not an affected thing, it's not put there. It's indigenous, it's in from the center and it flows out. And that was really excellent.
His interest was not using American Place Theater as a commercial venture, as a place to make money. It was always as a place to develop talent, both playwrights and actors and directors.
He was outspoken, he was rude, he was absolutely convinced of the rightness of the things that he was doing and why he was doing it.
Wynn is really the champion of nonprofit writers' theater.
I truly believe without him, I'd probably be lugging meat.
I love being in St. Clements.
Yeah, talk to me about that.
Takes me back to an enormously creative period of my life, where a whole new life began for me when we launched the American Place Theater here. 1962 was the first time I entered here.
Which leads me to my question. Yes. How does a nice Jewish boy from Inwood wind up in a church building a theater?
I started dreaming about this theater where you would do plays and do writers who would not be deemed commercial, but it would be a waste if their work wasn't done. He opened with the Old Glory, and then it had a series of huge successes after that.
Theater for him was never a competition with commerce the way it is now. He was idealistic in a lot of ways, but the American Place Theater tried out a lot of avant-garde plays at the time, always took chances, and I think left a lasting memory in a lot of actors' lives as a safe place to try a lot of things.
By doing the work that I felt I was supposed to do, it often challenged the audiences. People who subscribed would get impatient with it, and I had a lot of hostile mail and people resigning their subscriptions. By losing subscribers, those statistics show up with funders, the government and other funders, and say, why should we fund you? No one wants you. Your audience is abandoning you.
Was Wynn aware of how desperate this was? It used to be $5 a person if you can afford it. And I'm like, we're dead. We're dead in the water.
I was starting to find a much more rewarding life in the theater by creating the Literature to Life shows, sitting with the student audiences, and saying to myself, what audience is more important than reaching these young people? I'd like to be remembered that what I tried to do at the American Place Theater is to make up for the waste of talent that I see in my country. Everyone should do everything possible to give every opportunity to talent to flourish and not be hindered, watered down, left out because of commercial considerations.